that the focus on this conference was new technology, and I like to try to take you through some of the new technology, because it's always a development, and it's really important that the scientists make use of modern and accurate and new technology in order to get further in their work. The most of the land is well measured, but when you look at the sea in the polar regions, it's the less mapped places in the world. So it's important to get more research vessels and also for all countries to make use of the data which is taken up by one country. Because as it is today, most of the information is remain in the country who pick up the data. For research in polar regions, it's important to see what's the depth is. And when you have a multi-beam echo sounder, you can take away the water, and then you see the bottom like this. You can have a map like that. And that's important that in the future that we get better maps also in the polar regions. To do seabed mapping is not only for the safe transport, but it's also for energy, for geophysical minerals to see what's on the seabed, as well as for fishery and so on. We have the new Norwegian research vessel and icebreaker, Kronprins Haakon. And when you make a research vessel, and especially then an icebreaker, where you have a lot of scientific acoustic equipment on board, it's also a lot of challenges in how to install and where to install the equipment. Because acoustic sensors, which you have a lot of, has to be underneath the keel, and here you have the ice. So if you have a box keel, which has been heavily used now, then you can add a lot of sensors, multi-beams, in that part of the vessel. Deep water multi-beams, as well as other acoustic sensors. And if you look at more detail in how it's installed, you have the acoustic sensors and you have an ice window underneath. So that can go into ice, and it's also important that you have it in a box keel and below where you expect to have most of the ice. Same way, most research vessels have also the drop keels, where you can have smaller acoustic instruments. EK60 for marine life and geophysical seabed mapping, EM712, smaller sensors with higher frequency. So it's a lot of challenges into where to put acoustic instruments on research vessels. And like we in Kongsberg have a lot of recommendations. It's always a lot of new research vessels around the world coming up, and they more or less start to use now the same standard. Since this is about technology, it's also about how to integrate all the instruments on board from the acoustic sensors underneath. Here is shown the HiPAP echo sounders, but also the machinery, propellers, automation, even the bridge control. Everything is possible now to link together, and you can have all the data transmitted and shown in various stations on board the research vessels. Normally it can be 40-50 different stations, and then everyone can make use of the same amount of data. Here is just a diagram from some of the acoustics, which is a typical delivery from Kongsberg. You see all the sensors here is linked into the same network and can be shown on the screens. That's also an important task to do, is to link information together. When it comes to depth, it's a lot of deep water sections. We have a system going all to full ocean depth, 11,000 meters, multi-beam echo sonders, down to systems to 50 meters depth. So it's depend on frequency and the size of the transducers, and how much power you put out. But depends on the area you work in. But normally it's always a deep water multi-beam in the research vessels. We also add on to the multi-beam the sub-bottom profiler, where you can see fairly deep into the ground underneath the seabed. That's also important for geological research, to see how the forms are inside the bottom. If you look at the data, because a lot of vessels, like in hydrographic vessels, they are collecting data, but it takes up to 3 years before you see them in the chart. And that's not needed today. Today you can collect data, if you do it on an AUV or on the multibeam on the vessel. You can upload it to the cloud via satellite systems, and you can actually make use of it the next day, because the data today is that clean, so you do not need to do a lot of cleaning afterwards. That means you can make use of the data much faster than it has been done in the past, and that's a challenge as well. You can share data with other users, and you can do it as fast as you like, even though some data is national security, but basically this kind of data can be used for a long time, for many users, sorry. 15 minutes. Remote operation can also be used. You can have sit on the shore and even operate vessels abroad so the hydrographer, for example, or the scientist does not need to be on board. It can remote operate this one from the office. And we are in Kongsberg also have open standards, so it's everyone can connect other sensors to it, so we can easily get the data for them back. And here you see the map of the world, and like GEPCO and others are interested in getting a better measurement of seabed data worldwide. And that's a challenge for the whole world, how to do that better. On the research vessel, the sensors on the vessel itself has a limited range due to the water depth sometimes. And then to get a wider range, you can add on using AUVs or USVs, like here. And that means you can spread out of the sensors in a larger area to cover a larger area faster. I just show one AUV which is used now under ice in Antarctica, and we have several projects on that, where even when you have an iceberg, the AUV, when it swim here, will have a sonar looking upwards as well, so it will then go underneath automatically. That's pre-programmed. And if you're stuck in a situation where you have ice on top and the bottom coming up, it will turn and come back. So it's a lot of knowledge put into the system itself. I'd like to add a little bit about the new AUV which we are making now, where we have one customer have already ordered 15 6,000 meter AUVs. But we also make a new one now, which we name Hugin Superior, which will have double antenna synthetic aperture sonar, which means it can see 500 meters to each side of the vehicle, with measuring objects down to 3 to 5 centimeter resolution. That means this will be a fantastic tool. It's developed, yeah, more or less 50 minutes. And then with this system, together with multi-beam in the front, and laser scanning sonar, and camera underneath, you can also go down and look at objects. So developing and see what's going on the seabed, this is a super system for the future. Where you can see like sonar pictures, you can see bathymetry, you can as well have a accuracy in a autonomous mode, which is on 0.04% of the travel distance in accuracy, which is unique. It's no one else in the world which can come down to this accuracy autonomously. And you can get then, which is the result, as the researcher one, you can have pictures like this on a wreck or whatever on the seabed. In Kongsberg, we work with the governments, research institutes all over the world, a lot in Norway, University in Bergen, in Tromsø, and abroad, to work together with the research institutes in the way to develop new products which fits to the research work. A little bit of the summary is this kind of products is normally used on icebreakers worldwide, and I also hope to see that India is investing more in research vessels. We need that because we see in Russia they make 2-3 every year. Not Russia, so in China. China is very active in making new research vessels. So I hope to see that the Western world is taking up and doing more on the research side. But you have to invest. We have to invest. We do in Norway now, and also other countries is doing it because we need good equipment to also be able to discover more. Thank you.